Today, I want to tackle two issues dealing with apple trees. These two issues are bloom time and cross-pollination. Some apple trees produce sterile pollen, and some apple trees are self-fruitful, which means they produce pollen that can be used to pollinate other apple trees as well as themselves. Not all apple tree cultivars bloom at the same time. For example, here is a Dorset Golden apple tree, and it usually blooms in the late winter. Dorset Golden is not typically self-fruitful, which means it produces sterile pollen, so it needs to be pollinated by another apple tree to produce fruit. One solution to solving this issue would be to plant another apple tree cultivar close to this Dorset Golden apple tree that is self-fruitful and that blooms at the same time so that it can cross-pollinate this Dorset Golden apple tree. Another solution is available as well. Over here, about 30 feet away from this Dorset Golden, I have an Arkansas black apple tree. The Arkansas black apple tree is a triploid cultivar, which means it has sterile pollen as well and needs a self-fruitful apple tree to cross-pollinate it. So I grafted several scions of a self-fruitful apple tree onto the Arkansas black apple tree that bloomed at the same time as the Dorset Golden. The cultivar grafted was a shell apple tree. The shell apple tree is an old self-fruitful deep south heirloom apple that was developed by Mr. Green Shell, a Confederate soldier, in Escambia County, Alabama. It blooms at the same time as the Dorset Golden and produces ripe apples by July. The shell apple tree will self-pollinate itself and cross-pollinate the Dorset Golden or any diploid or triploid apple tree in close proximity, as long as the nearby apple tree blooms at the same time. So there you have it. It may be easier and more economical in terms of saving space to graft self-fruitful scion onto trees the way I did, especially for people that may not have a lot of space for multiple apple trees. One last thing. Triploid apple trees have three sets of chromosomes instead of two. However, this doesn't make triploid bad compared to diploid apple trees. In fact, triploid apple trees are usually more disease resistant and make bigger apples than diploid apple trees. This Arkansas black apple tree is a triploid, and in my opinion, it is a good choice for grafting self-fertile apple tree scion onto due to beneficial traits I just mentioned. Just remember, if you have a triploid apple tree, then you must have a way to pollinate it with non-sterile apple pollen. Thanks for watching, and I hope this has been helpful.